I'm here now in Gate 18. I'm waiting for the ground commander of the Philippine National Police, Colonel Hansel Marantan, in order to iron out supposedly some administrative matters as to how we can proceed further in this hullabaloo that is going on inside the KOJC compound. Specifically, I wanted to clarify with them because we already have some form of an agreement last night that any and all police officers who would go inside should be in proper uniform and that they should show their ID. And why we are politely insisting on this, simply because of the fact that under the civil code, the owner has a bundle of rights and he can determine who can enter his property. And even if they are in the service of warrant of arrest, they also have the right to our of our lives and liberties. We wanted to ensure that those who enter here are really policemen, and because there is a danger that there may be other elements who might take advantage of the situation and they might spread out violence here. So our request therefore was granted, but some police personnel would insist still in going inside. No, part of our agreement was that they can bring equipments, no? Even mining equipments. Of course, that is not proper in the service of warrant of arrest. But we have already voiced out our opinion on the matter. But they would insist that these equipments are needed in their continuous illegal search. So, so long as these equipments would be subjected to the scanner, so as to ensure also that there are no bombs there. There are no explosives there, so that the members can be assured of their protection. But then again, there was one incident again that one equipment was not caused to be x-rayed in our scanner, so there was again a commotion. And then another incident at 4 a.m. around 4 a.m., my associates, attorneys Adrian Pajaro and another lawyer, no, also had an almost violent confrontation with another police officer. You saw what happened because they wanted to remove some items here in the gate. It was our view that the owner of a facility cannot be dictated by the police as to what things they would put in their own property. That's within our civil code. But then again, in order to buy peace, we had to make some compromise, and at least the tension was eased, no? So I would like to address this TikTok or YouTube channel by one former dissident member, Miss White, ano ba yun siya? Who is actually propagating false news that there are now 8 heartbeats which are detected under JMC basement, no? And she was even able to identify from whose heartbeats were these, no? That's very amazing because even the PNP did not claim that, no? And I do hope the public would not believe that, because as of the present, there is no confirmation by the police that there were in fact heartbeats. What they showed us were mere pictures of a certain equipment. I do not even want to name the equipment. I am not a techie. Of two red dots shown first in the JMC main administration building. One police officer proudly declared that they noticed some heartbeats there. And then these heartbeats disappeared and then were found again in the JMC basement. And two, what you call this, red dots were shown in their equipment. And then these heartbeats were again shown randomly in the cathedral, no? And they show these to our lawyers. But we have yet to get a report from the PNP that there were 8 heartbeats that were seen. in the, what you call this, in the any part of the KOJC compound. So this report, therefore, by Ms. White is not true and should not be believed by the public, because it's very incredible that he was or she was even able to identify the identities from whose heartbeats were these. No, that's very incredible. We would also like to address the act of the Bureau of Immigration in preventing three KOJC members from Malaysia. No, they were here to attend the KOJC anniversary. Or they are here to attend the KOJC anniversary. They are not here to attend rallies, no? So, as you know, September 1 is the KOJC anniversary. In ordinary times, no, it would really be hard to move inside the huge compound of KOJC because of the sheer number of the followers. Unfortunately, today, no, very few managed to come, and even those who are brave enough to travel here from all over the world, because all members in the world would really strive hard to go into KOJC compound during anniversaries. It's like, to us Muslims, it's like your journey to Mecca, no? That can be likened to their faith, no? To us Muslims, if you go to Mecca, that's really a responsibility on our part, and we really go there, no? And KOJC members likewise do that here, no? But they were prevented simply because of a mere suspicion, no? I would like to address the Bureau of Immigration Commissioner, sir. Please allow them to enter because they would like to exercise their religious freedom. They have religious rights under the 1987 Constitution. I have no confirmation if they are Malaysian citizens, okay? Even if they are Malaysian citizens, please allow them, because even the United Nations Convention, no, allows people, whether of whatever race or nationality, they are allowed to exercise their faith, no. And the travel to Davao City to attend the KOJC anniversary is an act of faith. Please allow them to enter.
Ongoing pa rin po ba attorney ang railing sa loob? At saka may response na po ba si PNP Chief?
Unfortunately, wala pa hanggang ngayon. You know, part of our negotiation discussion with General Nicolas Torre yesterday in Acacia Hotel, no? Because he invited me three times, I did not respond, but finally I responded to him, was really to find ways how to prevent unnecessary tensions and commotions, no? And I requested him, as a human being, not as a general, to allow the KOJC members to at least celebrate with unbridled freedom, no? Today, September 1. But then again, he told me that that is beyond him. So I took it to mean that that is the decision of General Marbil. That's why I wanted confirmation from him.